Hi, this is Sam from RefnWrite. In this video, we will explain how to write a research paper that employs a survey questionnaire. We will discuss all the important points to consider while writing the research paper. The title of our research paper is Understanding Online Shopping Behaviors of Older Populations, a Questionnaire Study. Please note that this is not a real paper. It's an example paper we put together for the purpose of teaching. Let's start with the introduction paragraph. This is where you provide a general overview of the topic. It begins with a strong opening statement. This is normally called a hook, since you are trying to hook your readers to your paper. Here we are providing some interesting numbers about the elderly population. We are saying that by the year 2050, more than 30% of the world's population will be over 60. Then we follow it up with a future prediction. We are saying that the spending power of the elderly population will increase significantly in the next few years. This is a fantastic way to emphasize the importance of the topic. Now, with the next statement, we are highlighting the topic's timeliness. We are saying that this is a hot topic that has not yet been fully explored. Now let's move on to the literature review. A literature review is an overview of previously published works related to your topic. Let's start with a broad summary of the previous research activity in this field. We are saying that the topic of consumer behavior is well studied. Then we are grouping prior research into three main categories. This statement is a very good example of how to condense and summarize the findings of multiple research papers in one sentence. Now it's time to establish the research gap. A research gap is an unexplored or understudied area in the literature that you've identified. We are saying that there are very limited studies focusing on the consumer behaviors of the elderly population, and we are trying to address this particular gap in our work. Then we talk about the novelty component of our work. We are saying that, to the best of our knowledge, this is the first study to investigate this particular issue. Let's talk about research objectives. You have to describe what you intend to accomplish in your research. The aim of the study is to better understand the consumer attitudes and behavior of the older population. We will find this out by using a questionnaire survey. This concludes the introduction section of the research paper and lets us move on to materials and methods. This section should be written very clearly with a detailed account of the procedure that was followed in the experiment. The information in this section should be adequate for anyone desiring to replicate the study in the future. First, you have to explain how the participants were recruited for the study and clearly define your target population. In our case, we have decided to use customers over the age of 60 from an online shopping website. Then we have to explain how we selected the participants for the study. There are many different types of sampling methods. For example, we have random sampling, systematic sampling, convenience sampling, cluster sampling, and stratified sampling. In our case, we used a random sampling method, which means we randomly picked participants from the database. Now you have to explain how the questionnaire will be administered. There are so many different ways in which we can do it. We can do this via a phone interview, personal interview, written questionnaire, or online questionnaire. All the methods have both advantages and disadvantages. In our case, we used an online questionnaire that was emailed to the customers who agreed to participate in the study. Let's explain the number of questions the survey contains. In our case, we had 24 questions covering various topics. Here we are reporting the frequency of shopping in three categories: once a week, once a fortnight, and once a month. This is a close-ended question, since the answers are limited to a fixed set of responses. The participants must choose one of them. Then we'll use the Likert scale to understand how confident the participants felt while shopping online. The Likert scale is a very popular scale used to ask the participants how much they agree or disagree with a particular statement. We ask respondents to indicate what sort of stuff they typically purchase online. This is an open-ended question, and we use a free text box to capture the answers. The respondents are free to say what they like. This is particularly useful when you don't know how people are likely to respond to a question. Typically, an online questionnaire starts with a short description of the study, followed by the survey questions. In the end, you will ask the participants for demographic information, such as age and gender. It's also a good idea to provide a free text box so the participants can provide feedback or raise concerns about your study. Finally, thank your participants after completing the questionnaire. Make sure you do a pilot survey. This will help you identify any potential problems in your questions and allow you to fix them before it is too late. Keep repeating the pilot study until you're happy with the questionnaire. Let's move on to the results section. Start with the survey response numbers. In our case, the survey response rate was 31.6%. Then follow it up with demographic information of the respondents who participated in the study. In our case, we are presenting the demographic data in a table. Now, let's look at different ways to report survey data. One simple way of reporting is to provide the percentage of participants who chose a certain response for a question. In our case, 80% of respondents said they shop at least once a week. The question about the confidence of shopping was on the Likert scale. Here we are saying that the participants' average response was fairly confident. I must mention that there are so many other ways you can present Likert scale data. For example, you can visualize the entire distribution and present it as a figure in your paper. Another way of reporting data is by using broad generic terms, such as majority, minority, a large proportion, small proportion, etc. You can do this, but be careful because different readers might interpret these terms differently. Let's finish up the paper with a conclusion statement that nicely summarizes our work and key contributions. I hope you found the presentation useful. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you're interested in watching the extended version of this video and learning more about research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy. You can find the link in the description below. If you still haven't installed RefnWrite software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write a research paper or thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. And finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now.